Okay, hi, I'm Paul Dreik. I'm going to speak about stood forward. So this is going to be a beginner's talk. So stood forward was introduced in C++ 11. And it's coupled to move semantics, R values, L values, all that stuff. So I'm going to try to demonstrate with this live coding. See if we can get it big enough. Is this okay? No, oh, no, can't see it. Okay, so just clean up here a bit. This is my example program. I have a struct. I have a function taking a reference to a struct. So far, so good. So if I create an object and then invoke F on it, and then try to compile. You can see here down at the bottom. Try to make this bigger. So you see, the function gets called. That's what we expect. So that's good. So what now if we use a temporary object? So this will be an R value. So we get a compiler error. So that's because we have a non-const reference, which won't bind to an R value. So we will add an R value overload. Okay, that should do it. So let's compile and run. Yeah, you can see down here at the bottom that it selects the second overload. So this is good. This is what we expect. So now we'll see. What if we have a wrapper? So in this wrapper, I will invoke F. Oh, prep. No. So let's try this and see if it compiles. Yeah. So the reason for having a wrapper, maybe you want to run F in a try catch, or maybe you want to log something, then run F, whatever. Many reasons. So let's now try to invoke wrap instead of F. So on the L value, you can see down here, everything works as usual. We get the first overload, so that's good. So now let's try the second one on an R value. I forgot to change it. Oh, crap. I think I'm getting some kind of help here. Okay, that looks better. Okay, so now when I invoked wrap on an R value, we got the first overload. So that's wrong, because that's not the same thing as calling F directly. So this is where we're going to use stood forward. So we see this double ampersand, this is a forwarding reference. It was called universal reference, but now it's called forwarding references. So I'm going to use stood forward on t. So what this stood forward does is that it preserves the value category of its argument. So let's try this now. So I have the the L value version. So it selects the first overload. That's good. And we invoke it on the R value, we get the second overload. So now you see, we have a generic function which selects the correct overload. So this is what you use stood forward for. So there, if you dig into this, you can go quite deep, but this is most of what you need to know about stood forward. So I can note that you can't use stood move here. because that would be the wrong thing. That would unconditionally make it an R value. So stood forward is the right thing to do in this place. So I think Vittorio will speak more about making these generic functions transparent later. So thank you.